Hey guys, welcome back to the Northeast Florida Surf Fishing Forecast for this weekend, July 10th through the 12th. As you can see from the pictures, the fish are still here, scattered pompano, pretty good amount of whiting, croakers, and spots. There's also been Spanish mackerel, speckled trout, and yellowmouth caught. So there are fish to be caught. As you can see from this video I took this afternoon, the water is beautiful. The west winds have laid the surf down. There's still 2 foot surf coming in, and that's predicted to be 2 to 3 foot coming and going throughout the weekend. But there's no current to speak of with this west wind. In the next few days, the winds are pretty much the same each day, west in the morning, switching over to the southeast in the afternoon. The winds will be light in the morning, 5 to 8 out of the west. In the afternoon, southeast, 8 to 15. The water should stay clean, guys, as long as the wind doesn't switch over to the south greater than 15. If it does that, you can expect dirty water and then the usual stingray, catfish, and sharks. But let's hope that's not the case. The tides, Friday, low in the morning at 6:50 and a high at 12:51 in the afternoon. Then a low tide again at 7:01 p.m. Saturday, low at 7:35 in the morning. High at 1:36 in the afternoon and a low at 7:55 in the evening. Sunday, low at 8:21 in the morning, high at 2:23 p.m. in the afternoon, and a low again at 8:51 at night. Pretty good tides. You can get there early and fish the whole incoming tide before it gets too hot. I would bring top water if it's flat like this, because there are trout, speckled trout, cruising the surf right now all up and down the Northeast Florida beaches. Top waters, spoons, float rig with a live shrimp. Live mullet will work too if you can catch those. The baits of choice so far the last few days have been the fish bites. Shrimp and clam flavor. Fresh shrimp, of course. Sand fleas. Live shrimp, live mullet, spoons, and top water lures. The lures, guys, you can get them at most of the tackle shops. The mirror lures, especially the MR17. That's one of the best ones around. And as you can see, if you keep watching, I have some video of the sand fleas that are in Jack's Beach right now. They are absolutely everywhere. I haven't seen the sand fleas this thick in several years. Let's hope this trend continues, because the more bait, more fish that are going to be cruising the surf. Also, if you'd like to try your hand at something a little bit bigger, there have been plenty of tarpon cruising the surf and the inlets the last week or so. They're chasing the mullet and the pogies. So if you get out there early in the morning, I'm talking about the crack of dawn, those tarpon will really be in shallow. So if you can catch some big mullet, pogies, even croakers or spots, and what you want to do is use a, you know, 40, 50 pound fluorocarbon with a big circle hook. And no weight. I would use a spinner if you could. You need a lot of line, so preferably 300 to 500 yards of line, because let me tell you, those tarpon will take a lot in a hurry. But anyways, a big circle, fluorocarbon. I like to hook the fish under the tail, so they swim up on the top. And I'll put a video up on that sometime this week when I get a big one. But throw it out past the breakers if you can. Let it swim on top, and usually those tarpon will nail it. You've got a circle hook, so remember, once he's on there, you don't really need to set the hook. If you set the hook, you're going to pull it right out of his mouth. And they're good at throwing the hooks anyway, so don't be discouraged if you have a hook up and lose it, guys. Also, right now in the surf, there's big jacks and barracudas, so you can get the jack, but if a cuda hits the fluorocarbon, typically it'll just bite right through it. Also, plenty of big sharks. If you're going to shark fish, remember to go to the FWC website and do everything you need to do. And now on to the sand fleas. When I got down there and walked to the shore, I'm telling you, they were everywhere. Look at this video as wave goes out. All those little ripples, those are all sand fleas. And it was like this as far north and as far south as I looked down the beach. You know, last week there was a lot of sand fleas, but not like this. They are just thick right now. So it's free bait, guys. There's no excuse. One thing to keep in mind when you're trying to catch these sand fleas, as you can see, the smaller sand fleas tend to be in a little bit shallower water. They sit up there higher on the sand where the wave is barely touching. And then as you go out deeper, like today, literally 3 or 4 foot past the small sand fleas, all the big sand fleas were there. And it was just ridiculous. As you can see, just using my hand, every scoop, probably 10 to 12 of the small sand fleas. Great bait, guys. Pompano, whiting, redfish, drum, sheephead hit them. Also, big stingrays. The big stingrays love them. Lots of small ones. These were the big ones. They're out a little bit deeper. Almost too big to use. I'll use them though. If they're too big, what you can do is cut them in half, and they work just fine like that as well. Because I would try to stay away from putting on more than one sand flea. I have done it when they're small. I have put two and three on at a time, and it does work. Which, as you can see, these are good sized sand fleas, guys.
This is what's inside the sand flea and what the pompano and whiting love. See all those eggs? They absolutely destroy them. And that's what they're after when they're trying to eat the sand flea. So it's important you hook them the right way. So typically, when you're catching sand fleas, there's usually about three sizes. You got the small guy, medium guy, and then the big boy. Personally, the medium size is the best. I like to use this size the most. And if I can only get the smaller ones, that'll work too. I'll put two on at a time and it works great. I'm gonna show you how I hook them now too.
Here's the eggs. So you push that little flap down. Up. Take the hook. Just like that. Make sure they can't get to the eggs and it won't kill the sand flea, because up here is where they breathe and everything. But it's simple, just like that. Try it out. Don't forget, for tides specific to the area that you're fishing, to go to this app, tidesforfishing.com or Tide for Fishing app. It'll help you out. And also, you can check this website out. It gives the water temperature. Just type in the area you want to fish and you'll know the water temperature. And if you haven't yet done it, we're almost to 500 members now, and we have daily reports for the water and the wind. Until next time, tight lines.